sister, close to me like my brother. You are the only one, you're my everything. And for you, the song I sing.
Together in celebration of your marriage. Many friends and family have gathered together to celebrate this occasion. I'd like to share a few words in behalf of what the Lord has established for you as you join this union. You may all have a seat at this time. Men and women are intended to progress towards exaltation. The Lord has commanded that husband and wives cleave to each other and none else. In this commandment, the word cleave means to completely be devoted and faithful to one another. Married couples cleave to God and one another by serving and loving each other and by keeping the covenants in complete fidelity and to one another and to God. A couple has become one in establishing a family as the basis of a righteous life. Husband and wives leave behind the single life and establish marriage as a first priority in their lives. They allow no other person or thing to come between them. They allow all things to be such that keeping the covenants they have made with them and God are our first priority. Nonetheless, married couples continue to love and support their parents and siblings while focusing on their own families. Similarly, wise parents realize that the family responsibilities continue throughout life in a spirit of love and encouragement. Being one in marriage requires a full partnership. For example, Adam and Eve worked together, prayed and worshiped together, sacrificed together, taught their children the gospel, and mourned over wayward children. They were united with each other and with God. The first commandment that God gave to Adam and Eve pertaining to the potential for parenthood as husband and wife was to multiply and replenish the earth. Fathers are to preside over the families in love and righteousness and are responsible to provide for the necessities of life and protection for their families. Aaron David Diaz and Kaitlin Diana Homone, if you please take each other by the right hand. Aaron David Diaz, do you take Kaitlin Diana Homone as your lawfully wedded wife, and do you, of your own free will and choice, covenant as her companion and lawfully wedded husband that you will cleave unto her and none else, and that you will observe all the laws, covenants, and obligations pertain to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love and honor and cherish her as long as you both shall live? Kaitlin Diana Homone, do you take Aaron David Diaz as your lawfully wedded husband, and do you, of your own free will and choice, covenant as a companion and lawfully wedded wife that you will cleave unto him and none else? And that you will observe all the laws, covenants, obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish him as long as you both shall live? By virtue of the legal authority vested in me as an elder of the Church of Jesus Christ Latter-day Saints, I pronounce you, Aaron David Diaz and Kaitlin Diana Homone, as husband and wife, legally and lawfully wedded for the period of your mortal lives. May God bless this union with your joy and posterity and long life and happiness together. And may you be able to keep the covenants that are sacred. These blessings I invoke upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You may now kiss the bride.
Pleasure is on the other side.